Oh, I'm coughing. Hello, welcome back to... Well, I have no idea what set this is, but...
It's a set. Here, we're doing the Let's Play. Oh, hi, I'm caffeinated Katie Gorey, and this is your actual host, Alakan Lunex. We are here playing Tie the Tasmanian Tiger, where we are finishing the second area.
On the radio! You do sound like a radio DJ.
I do right now. This is my announcing voice, which only happens when I've been incredibly caffeinated.
Yes, because you haven't slept.
That too!
Well,
yeah.
Barely, anyway. I hate the fact that I always forget that this game is reversed. Ooh, never touching that one again.
Yeah, that was a terrible episode and a terrible level.
Yes.
But not so much a terrible episode, but, you know, this time, at least, there's no discount racism.
Oh.
Yeah, I'm not going to say anything, but yeah, thanks for the massive caption. Audio omitted due to inappropriate humor. Thanks for that.
What?
Way to throw me under the fucking bus.
Well, you didn't actually say it, so it's not like they're going to come after you as a lynch mob.
Yeah, true. Plus, I was racist against white people, so that's acceptable.
Yes. That's totally acceptable. This person, or this koala bear, is the worst mother ever.
That is a theme, a recurring theme in this game.
How does she lose 8 children?
I don't know. That's impressive. I think that's a new record. How many did the agendered horse seahorse do?
8 also. These parents like to have children in a series of 8.
Yeah, that's weird.
Because it makes it more challenging if there's more of them.
I guess, but then the logistics of it don't seem to make much sense when you think about it.
No.
Okay.
I mean, she's gonna be pretty sore, you know? Because yeah. They're all the same age.
Gonna need some alcohol for that one.
Mm. Although this does have one of my favorite enemy types.
What are these guys?
The kangaroos and the jumpers, because they throw snowballs at you.
They throw snowballs and then they wave politely and then you beat them to death.
Oh, excuse me.
Front door. I can edit this, so it's
alright. Okay. So, whilst your host is gone, how about we start that demonic summoning, shall we? I don't actually know any words to it, but you know. Whatever, it is worth a shot. Suspicious package?
Why, thank you.
Wait, what?
It's wax.
Oh.
I'm making candles.
Oh. It's interesting. I wish I had hobbies.
You do! You do!
Okay, back from our brief time warp.
Whoosh.
So yeah, these kids playing in the snow and here's us beating them to death with brutal hunting weapons.
These aren't kids. These are adults, clearly.
Why the fuck are
adults
playing snowball
fights? Because they throw snowballs. Adults don't do that, they just hide in the snow. And they whistle.
Yeah.
And then just slowly fade into the void.
Huh. That's weird.
Yeah, this game's weird.
Yeah.
As a general rule.
The early 2000s. What a traumatic time for us all.
Certainly. If you need a bit of a speed boost. And you want to shred your feet.
Yes.
Because, you know, he's barefoot. Sliding on ice, that'll hurt.
It's painful.
Yeah. That'll hurt quite a lot.
Especially if you're barefoot.
Yeah.
Or, like, exclusively if you're barefoot. I'm not even sure.
I don't know, really. Now, is this one of the ones I can set on fire? No. This one's one of the kids.
Oh.
Oh, jeez.
We get it, you're Australian.
Yep. I don't know why these enemies are hiding in ice.
It'd be funny if you broke one of them and they were just dead from hypothermia.
Yeah, that would have been hilarious.
Yes, it would have been hilarious. Thank you for backing up my point.
Though,
I'm a horrible person.
What I can do... Oh no, I haven't got it yet. I thought I could freeze them, but I haven't actually got
it
yet.
Yeah, you need the icy rain for that, don't you?
Frosty rain.
Frosty rain, whatever. Same thing.
Gah. Icy rain.
Yeah, let's just flash back to before this Let's Play. When was the last time I played this game? Sorry if I don't have all the lore down.
That was a boy saying oi.
Yeah. Is this like the seahorse? Are we gonna have to decide what their genders are?
Yeah. Well, maybe they're just trying to be gender fluid so that it's acceptable for all people.
It doesn't work that way. No, Tumblr can shut up. It doesn't work that way.
Thankfully, this isn't Tumblr. Cheating.
Yeah, kinda.
I love the fact that he can do that.
Yeah, the homing attack biting.
Yeah, it's very, very useful.
Homing attacks. Because that wasn't an element in a game that may or may not have come out at roughly the same time.
Trying to think what you're thinking about. Ratchet and Clank with the ratchet?
No. And the color swapped, edgy version of the main character. I'm thinking about Sonic.
Oh. I see.
Come on, it's so easy to make that comparison.
What, between this and Sonic?
Kinda.
Other than the current fact that we are now going fast, I don't see much.
And the collecting, and the,
okay, yeah, the
edgy
collecting.
Counterpart with the different palette.
Yeah, I'm seeing that. but there are no weapons in Sonic, as far as I know.
There are
other
some
than
characters
Amy Rose
that
has
have
a
lasers.
Fucking hammer.
You don't play as Amy Rose in that game.
Oh.
Thankfully.
Yeah, that is a good thing.
But there's you can play as Tails, and he has like this mech that you pilot.
I thought Tails just hit people with his balls.
No.
You know, when he was on the ball, like Sonic does.
No, that was, you think of the 2D ones.
Yes.
Except the one where Tails actually has all the weapons. I forgot which one that is.
How the fuck did this child get here?
Because reasons, okay? Because reasons.
Also,
irresponsible parents.
This ice hurts you. Because it's spiky.
Logic.
Hmm. You just have to touch it, and it throws you back.
Yeah, I've never really understood that. Like, if there were spikes pointing at me horizontally, I'm not gonna just charge straight into them and impale myself on them.
No, it should have like a... It should have a back-off animation if you got too close.
Yeah.
These motherfuckers.
What, someone just enjoying their day snowboarding?
These motherfuckers, I hate them. For one thing, they spawn out of the ground, and then when they stop, they just disappear.
Weird.
I'm gonna see if I can try and catch it. Whoop, the inverted camera makes me not do that. Holy shit.
I remember hating this area because of how huge it was and the fucking ice mechanics.
Wow, this guy's going far.
Yeah.
I don't remember him going this far.
God, the controls are awful when you're on ice. Oh yeah, and the completely pointless sniper scope that can kill enemies in one hit, because the other boomerangs don't kill enemies in one hit.
No, they don't do that. That'd be actually, some of them don't.
Yeah.
Come to think of it, because there are blue tongue lizards that we've been dealing with, the ones that have the boulders that throw shit at you.
Yeah, I always thought you had to kill them with bite.
You can. I'm pretty sure most enemies die with one hit from the bite.
Yeah.
But the blue tongue lizards die from two hits from any regular boomerang. The flamerang takes one hit.
Yeah, it's kind of like we were saying the other episode where...
Oh, you watched the other episodes? I can't remember that.
Yeah. Where we're basically talking about how, like, the implementation of the different boomerangs was kind of poorly done, because it's... A lot of the boomerangs are left pointless because, yeah, a lot of the other ones kill in one hit.
Yeah, you don't really need them. They're just, you know, for...
They're for gimmicks.
Yeah. They're there for you to enjoy, because they do lots of fanciful things. And they look pretty.
Yeah,
some
like,
of them do look
I
pretty.
Do love the flames.
Yeah, the flames are amazing.
Fucking kids whistling you. I'm not a waiter.
And why the hell they were up there, I'm not going to question.
Get up there.
koala bears. Because, you know, they're the most energetic of creatures.
Completely. It's not like they're half comatose on a daily basis because of their terrible diets. An evolutionary thing which could have been avoided had they chosen to eat literally anything else.
Yeah. I don't know why they even decided to choose.
Not the smartest animals.
No, really not.
Literally the dumbest mammals.
I wonder what would happen if you actually fed them things like meat.
They wouldn't know what to do with it.
Yeah, but if you like force fed them, do you think they'd become more energetic? Would that be kind of freaky?
I'm not sure. Like, to my knowledge, other animals that if you try and make them eat something they can't digest, they just keel over.
Good point.
Maybe. It causes a blockage in their system because their body can't process it.
Hmm. I don't know who made these.
Those are very
neat.
Uniformly made.
Yeah.
I think I remember as a kid giving up on that one because I didn't realize that the stack was dropping. I just thought it was indestructible or something.
Oh.
Yeah, I wasn't. I didn't understand the concept of video games.
Or physics in general,
which is weird because, you know, my physics background now.
Yeah. Quite. That's a pointless enemy area.
Yeah.
And three opals. Just on their own.
There are four reasons.
Just some to make it extra difficult so that you can't get them all in this level. Because, you know, when you first play it, you're not likely to get them all in this level.
Yeah, I know, I didn't.
No. I didn't in some occasions. Like, the long play I did, I lost one there.
Yeah.
But that wasn't quite my fault. One of them had clipped through the wall.
Mm. It's always fun when that happens.
Yeah, the only way I could find it was with a cheat, which was annoying.
I don't know why, but it's only recently I've actually started, like, playing these games and properly making an effort to collect everything.
Yeah, well, you get a different kind of story if you do actually do the thing it wants you to do.
Yeah, if you actually play the game.
If I hit that with just a regular boomerang, he takes it like a man. Two of them kills.
Because let's face it, those things are hench as fuck.
Yeah.
Hell of a jawline.
Yeah.
And then the frill lizards, the twink motherfuckers.
Yeah, and you're looking at their bellies through their shirts.
Shut up!
Well, it's not like I've ever done that with Tai. Gosh.
Yeah, totally.
Mm-hmm. I mean, he is wearing shorts, after all.
In the cold!
Yeah, he's dead.
It would have been hilarious if they had made, like... In this level, his idle animation had, like,
Curious. Does
steam
he have
breath?
One?
Or his idle animation was him shivering?
Yeah, I'm not actually sure if there is one.
Because, you know, in World of Warcraft, when you get closer and closer to the colder areas, your character's breath starts going up in steam. Which is a really cool detail.
That is nice. Just a regular animation.
Yeah,
I don't want to sit through them all, because there's quite a few... Right, okay.
I just like details like that.
Yeah,
know?
That's
it's always
that's
it's
a nice
always
touch.
The really small details which people appreciate the most.
Exactly.
Just shows things are well thought out, you know?
Yeah, like that glitch we found with his jaw.
Yeah, although it's not so much of a detail, more of like a fuck-up.
Yeah. Fun though.
But you know, Chrome, we love you for it. I know we spend a lot of these Let's Plays bitching about your games, but no, we seriously do enjoy them.
Yeah, your game is just amazing. I think about the best way of going about this.
Now, isn't there like a golden cog or a thunder egg that's at the bottom of an ice lake?
Yeah, over there.
Yeah.
There is some breakable ice, which also leads to this breakable ice. It's like an underground tunnel.
Right, even though people can, on average, last about 30 seconds in water that cold before they start to freeze to death.
He's got fur on, it's okay.
That'd just make it worse, because the fur would get waterlogged. It'd drown him quicker.
Okay, going upwards through this area was a bad idea.
It's really weird if you like if you read the science of what happens if you fall into an ice lake, because all of this involuntary stuff happens. Isn't this cheery, by the way?
Oh yeah, this is.
Yes, I'm very morbid. Do you know what KD Gory stands for? Komodo Dragon, and then because I was a gore artist.
Yeah. I'm glad you stick with that name. It's a good name.
Yeah, it rolls off the tongue a bit.
Well, I say it's a good name. I mean... That's kind of a bit egotistical.
You did come up with it.
It's brilliant. You should have thought of it earlier.
You thought of it, as a matter
of fact. I'm trying to make it so that you did.
But... No, I didn't.
Okay, I think... No, we're not. I thought we knew in the beginning. This level is just humongous.
It is, which is so off-putting.
It is, especially considering what we've done is about a third.
It's like a collectathon of this scale.
That's fucking massive.
A collectathon of this scale in a level like this, it just, it hurts.
Yeah. Is this the last one?
I think it is.
Is it? Yes. Good. So now we need to go back to talk to the absentee mother.
Yep. Who didn't go looking for her kids herself.
Have you noticed that there is only one parent in these child situations?
Yeah, but not in like a Pixar way.
No. Not in like a Pixar way.
Because for some reason, Disney in general has a phobia of parents. Or at least, happy parents.
6, 7. Not even looking 8. At them. All accounted
for? Damn! I was hoping to claim on the fucking...
Boonie.
Yeah.
Fucking Boonie.
Fucking Boonie. You can have it if you want it.
No, I'll show you Boonie.
Like, shit, I was hoping to, like, cash in on insurance or something.
That one's Boonie.
Yeah, Derp Eyes.
Although, it's hard to tell, because each one of them is replicated.
Alec! That what? Is racist,
no,
man!
No, it's not. Fucking look.
They all look the same, huh?
Two of them look the same. She had four sets of twins. And we can do the time trial now, but
fantastic.
We won't.
Let's not.
No, because we haven't actually explored the rest of the level yet.
So unnecessarily big.
It is. I mean, we can see it in the distance, actually.
Yeah, I mean, that's a nice detail and all, but still, fucking hell.
Yeah. It makes it worse because of all these opals scattered around. I mean, I know they're directional orbs, but I don't like it.
Yeah, I think I'm kind of in agreement on the idea that they should be direction orbs.
Yeah.
That basically they lead you through the level in like the most scenic way.
Well, actually, they're quite direct.
Yeah, I know they're in like a they're in a path now, but still.
And all the way through this level, they go through the shortest route to get from the start to the finish.
Yeah, but they're not like all bunched together. All 300 of them are
no.
on the same path.
Yeah. Okay.
You have to actively seek them out, which is kind
well, not all 300 are on the same path.
I suppose it compels you to explore the levels a bit more, which I can understand, mm-hmm. but. To be perfectly honest, I'm not really tempted to explore.
The ice on these lakes is very thin, mate.
Tread carefully or you'll break. Like, I don't think this... Now, this isn't, like, a bad point. I'm just saying that this isn't really an exploration game.
No, it's not. And it makes it difficult for ice levels, because I hate ice physics in games.
Yeah, they never seem to work right.
I mean, just look at this. This is
You're
ridiculous.
All over the place. I mean, yeah, they're always kind of difficult. I think, I'm trying to think of a game where the ice physics worked well.
That is a toughie.
I'm not going to count games like Undertale because, I've had like a real Undertale fixation recently. Fucking sue me for it. But,
Okay,
yeah. But in games like that, you basically just slide over the ice completely.
Mm.
But it's not really... It happens so infrequently. I think there's only like one or two patches of ice
there's
in
that game.
There's
a couple of occasions, yeah, but not very many.
No, I think there's literally two.
Oh, right, okay. Well, that's a couple though, isn't it?
Yeah. I was just thinking, trying to remember how many there were, and then it just struck me. Actually, three. There are three patches of ice in that game, I think.
Are you sure there aren't four? Are you sure?
Don't quote me on that. Hey, we're gonna do an Undertale Let's Play after this.
They can pull a hot rock out of the floor.
That's impressive.
Out of ice.
Yes.
Not only that, but its hitbox is exists until it disappears. So if I kill it when it's holding it, it will fall to the ground, but I can still get damaged off it.
No.
I don't know if that's a good thing.
It's a detail.
Wrong one.
So if they're holding it, then you kill them, and the rock drops to the floor.
Yeah. During that time, if you touch the rock, it will damage you.
That's... Okay, yeah, it doesn't make much sense unless the rock was on fire.
Yeah, which is what I think they were going for, because it looks red, like the lava rain. The flame rings are.
Yeah.
It's kind of crackled.
Yeah. Well, you know what? We're doing an Undertale Let's Play directly after we finish this one.
Probably not today.
Obviously not today.
No, because if we finish this game today, it'll take us another 3.5 hours, perhaps.
Probably. And this is gonna be cool, because for the first time ever, Alex is gonna be taking the backseat on this one.
I know.
I fucking rock at Undertale. I know all the secrets.
It's perfect, and I didn't get further than like halfway, so.
You got about 3/4, which is a good effort, by the way. Good effort. Omega Flowey's a bastard.
Yeah.
I'm awesome at killing him. But anyway, I think we could make that like a, if we decide to record the Omega Flowey battle, we can make that like a bonus episode. Because you can do the true ending Let's Play, just like straight from start to finish without having to go through another neutral play.
Alright.
So yeah, that's basically, you only have to kill Omega Flowey once in a full playthrough.
That's good. That is very useful.
Yeah. I mean, I personally enjoy that boss fight.
Oh. I'm a freak. You're probably one of the only ones.
Yeah, I'm a bit of a masochist.
Let's try this again.
Missed.
It's alright, you don't actually touch it until you jump.
Yeah.
And then you float.
Which is weird.
Also, the ice doesn't reform
until you're out.
Until you're out.
That's a nice detail.
Well, it doesn't make sense, but it is a nice detail. It would be better if it did reform and you'd have to shoot it to get out.
Yeah, or Ty would drown horribly.
Yes. Oh, I actually killed it. Nice.
Because the boomerangs home in on enemies somehow.
Yes, they do.
Even if you weren't aware of those enemies' existences.
I love the fact that they actually created a specific homing boomerang when the fact that they all do it.
Yeah.
Though the Megaran does home into multiple enemies, which is very nice.
It daisy chains them, unless you get that ridiculous scenario, which we might experience.
We will.
Where it just, like, sticks to them until their armor breaks, which is never.
No. When we go to the other sea level, I can't remember what it's called. It's all called Shipwrecks. What's the other one called? Rex Marks the Spot.
That's the one.
When we go to Rex Marks the Spot, you'll notice the enemies that have shields, and Megaran can't deal with that shit.
Yeah, it just gets lodged. In my experience, it did anyway. But, yeah, I'm really looking forward to this this new Let's Play we'll be doing, and then we're moving on to Tai 2. Have we decided that?
Yeah. Awesome. I'd like that. Because I'm doing my Tai 3 Let's Play currently.
Yeah, I noticed that.
And then when we are done with Tai 2, we'll move on to Tai 3 as well.
Cool.
Hopefully.
Yeah, it's gonna be a bit of a change. And yeah, we can then count the ice patches in Undertale, if it'll make you happy.
Count the ice patches?
It'll make me happy.
What do you mean, count the ice patches?
Because we said there's a couple, and then we...
Oh, right,
it was,
I see.
Just a couple minutes ago.
Yeah, okay. I thought you meant, like, some kind of game. I was like, what on earth are you talking about?
Jeez, and you said I was sleep-deprived.
Hey, I'm just really forgetful. And I'm playing a game.
True.
Imagine what it's going to be like for you, when you're going to be playing Undertale.
I'm just going to be gushing the whole time.
Oh, shit, I didn't push the button. Never mind. I'll get the orbs first. Opals. I keep on calling them opals.
Orbs. They are opals, so you just keep calling them orbs.
Yeah, I know. I meant the other way around. I keep on calling them orbs, but they are in fact opals.
What is wrong with you today?
I don't know. It's your fault. I'm gonna specifically blame you.
Aww. Sure, blame the lizard.
Yeah, that's how it works. Lizards are always to blame.
Yes. We are the scum of this earth.
Yeah. Nope. Nope. Fucking no.
Denied!
There we go. Got to aim a little bit down.
Yes. I will say, I am enjoying the soundtrack on this level.
Not my favourite. It is a good one, but it's not my favourite.
It's not my favourite either, but in general, it's a nice song.
Bridge Over the River Tai is definitely one of the best.
Yes. Our episode with the most bitching.
Yes.
Again, Chrome Studios, we apologise.
Oh shit, I'm gonna drown.
I mean, I know you're not watching this at all, but just, yeah, in general.
You know, I've never heard that sound effect before, because I've never gotten that before. Oh shit. Thankfully, you don't take damage underwater, you just lose air.
Which just doesn't make sense.
No, it doesn't.
It's like the Super Mario Bros. Thing.
Mm. Well, he can metabolize metal, so... Heaven knows how that works.
Yeah. Wait, is that... Do you mean, like, when you...
Have coins
and
you can restore not only health, but air supply.
Seriously?
Yeah, so if you have coins underwater, you replenish your air.
That is amazing, and I don't know why I never noticed that. Yeah, these levels take it out of us.
Yeah, because they're just so dull. It's so repetitive.
And yeah, the good news is we got Rex Marks the Spot and Beyond the Black Stump to look forward to.
And Liar Liar.
Yes, which are the three longest, most repetitive ones. Except for Liar Liar.
I like Liar Liar, because I love the character plenty.
Yeah.
He is an amazing character.
He's a little shit.
He is, but he's an amazing character.
Yes.
I'm sure... Well, we also have two bosses. We have the boss from this area, which is Crikey.
Yep.
And Fluffy.
Yeah. That name doesn't make much sense.
It doesn't. But, you know, people who make these kind of games do that. I mean, just look at Tiny Tiger from Crash.
Yeah.
So you've got a fluffy lizard, you know, that's how it works.
I kind of remember enjoying Fluffy's boss fight.
I couldn't figure it out when I was
Cass.
Because you've got to do it in the right order.
Material, yeah, that's true. Secret project of
his. Which we will never find out. I reckon there's
something up top. Yeah, it's that secret. See if you
can find yeah, it's that secret. no worries. We never find out. It's just a sawmill. That's it.
Yes.
There's nothing exciting about that, Mori.
And he's building a giant robot. I'm not sure what part of that requires lumber.
No. Nor I. Maybe for fuel? Because he's that much of a dick?
Yeah, but...
He's just going to burn trees?
Wood is a very inefficient fuel source.
No, but with wood you can make coal. You can,
Well...
What's it called?
You can kind of make charcoal.
Yeah, but what's the process? There's a name for it.
I forget, but it requires
like
fuel.
Yeah, it does. But you can burn the wood to make the charcoal, then you can use the charcoal to make more charcoal.
Or you can be smart and use petroleum.
Or you can do that. But, you know, this is a video game.
Yeah, and, you know, game logic.
Also, stairs are almost invisible when you look down at them.
Which is very inefficient. Yeah, I remember that about this level. I always found, like... I could always go up here, but I can never get down the same way.
Yeah, because you can't see the stairs.
Yeah, and once you collect all the opals, the trail is invisible.
What do you mean?
As in, once... If you collect all the opals and then look at this area from above, then it's really hard to find, because the area... The path is concealed, because it's the same color as the rest of the environment.
Ah, I see. I think I'm going the wrong way. So, let me at least show you this idiot here. spawns there.
Seriously? That... What? What am I looking at?
So it's great just to just wait for them and shoot. Oh, because I'm standing on the spawn point, it moved into the tree.
You mean they couldn't, like, just put something there to make them spawn out of?
No.
Jeez.
Just comes out of the tree.
It was like a snowboarding lodge or something that's like built into the side of the cliff, and they just came out the door.
Yeah, that would be nice.
But that would require effort.
It would. That's too much effort.
I don't like the noise the sawmill makes, to be honest.
Really?
It's very annoying.
Oh, I see. I thought you meant like traumatizing. Don't like it.
No, it's just irritating.
Glitching textures.
Oh. What the hell is doing that?
When I move, when the camera moves, actually.
Oh, is it because you're like standing on an intersection of two polygons?
No idea.
Jeez, listen to me using all that game jargon.
Yeah. What's the matter with you?
Yeah.
You've been playing too many games.
No, I've been like building assets for too many games.
Oh, I see.
Dude, I did 3D at university. I'm gonna use words like that.
Well, I don't always get them.
I'm fairly sure that most people don't, but it's okay.
Yeah, you're just doing it to sound smart, though, aren't you?
Yes! Because I'm insecure.
Okay.
Thank you for noticing.
That's okay. That's what I'm here for.
I will say, though, I tend to use long words just because I enjoy using long words.
Same here. I do enjoy using long words. Except when I'm in the presence of somebody who I know will not fully understand, even after I've explained
it. Oh, yeah, definitely. Then you kind of, like, tone down your vocab.
Yeah.
It's like, if I'm at work, I'm not going to use some of the words I know, because no one would get it.
Nope.
And then the conversation becomes very one-sided.
It does.
Like all of our Let's Plays.
Not completely. I do try and pay attention. Ugh, I hate this area. Can never remember which way to go.
Yeah.
Right, we're
Chrome,
at the top
we love
now.
You, but still, what were you thinking?
Mm.
I think I have this theory that there's this part of every game where it's like the idea mill is churning up like some pretty it's churning up pretty weakly.
Mm-hmm.
And there's like these whole segments of games which just have they're either very repetitive, or there's like they're very bare.
Mm.
And I'll give an example. It's not Ty.
Okay.
You've played Half-Life, right?
I have seen a Let's Play of it, so I know how it works.
Well, in Half-Life and Half-Life 2, in Half-Life, it's the area with like the giant like trains and all that.
Okay.
We're going through like the maze of like train tunnels.
Yeah.
But that is... It's so barren. There's nothing there.
Hmm.
There's nothing going on, and it kind of makes me think, do they just briefly just think, right, we don't know what to do with this area, so let's just add, like, a load of train tunnels and then break it up every now and then with guys shooting at you?
Hmm. You're okay with spiders, right?
I'm fine with spiders.
Good.
I love spiders.
Good to know.
Yeah, I'm one of the few people that find spiders genuinely adorable.
I wouldn't say adorable, but they don't exactly scare me.
But they got their little eyes. Okay, that noise is hilarious. The scuttling noise.
All done.
That was easy.
Yep.
They really do make you OP.
Fuck you.
Wow! That's like...
He evaded a boomerang.
One of the only times you've ever taken damage.
I do take damage, but I haven't actually died yet.
No. I thought you were going to when we were playing the Outback Safari level.
Yeah, I was getting very close there.
Just because that level's ridiculous.
Redonkulous.
That's a good word.
It is a good word.
Is the megabyte, whatever the fuck it's called,
yeah.
Is that basically just the daisy-chained byte attack?
Yes.
That is ridiculous.
You get it every time you reach 100 overalls.
I know you do.
Oh, did that? Yeah, did you... They've actually come back.
Oh. You explained that one to me in our first episode.
Screw it. Okay, I didn't know if you'd actually remembered, so...
Yeah,
because, because you never know, some people just go into the middle of Let's Plays. People do that.
Yeah.
So it's not just for you, it's also for the audience.
Yeah, I've personally never understood the whole going into the middle of something. I personally can't do it.
What do you mean by going into the middle of something? Like, well, in the middle of the Let's Play?
Yeah, the example you just used, but also, like, a series or even a film.
Oh, yeah, yeah. No, I can't do that, because you lose out on everything. The story, the relationships.
So at that point, what are you even watching?
You're just watching it because someone else is. That's the only reason you would watch something midway through.
I suppose.
Because someone else had started.
Okay, what are these saw blades cutting?
And what's controlling them? You may notice that the center, that the thing that actually spins it, is
just
floating. There's nothing there. It's just a saw blade.
And they're the wrong way. The saw blades are supposed to go... They're supposed to cut things vertically, not horizontally.
That would be cutting it up in half. But maybe this is cutting it up into sections.
Yeah, but there are other machines that do that.
Yes, there are other
In a setup machines. Like this, this would be something like a huge piece of lumber is sliding down this thing.
Hardly. And it's being cut in sharp angles. Wood isn't going to go around there.
Exactly, but that's an entirely other problem with this setup. No, we're just scratching the surface of what's wrong with this.
This is where I lost one. It was stuck in the wood.
Oh, that's weird.
But I think I've gotten more now.
Yeah, hopefully.
I also don't have the Mega Ring yet, which is...
Disappointing.
It is disappointing. I need the Mega Ring.
It's alright, we'll get it in the next area.
Probably.
Because the last level has no collectibles, so that kind of lines it up quite nicely, so we have the last level to have Ty's full arsenal, and only use a single one.
Yeah.
Or at least that's how I played it. Literally only use the Kaboomerang.
Really?
Because it's so fucking funny.
Yeah, and very overpowered. This box. Annoying.
Yeah, because...
It's in an area that you're not supposed to go to.
Yeah, that's weird.
Because there's no direct path to it.
It's like the developers are expecting you to break the game.
Yeah. Alright, I think... That's it.
So if you think if you guys out there think that we have very little to talk about in areas like this, just wait till Ty 2, where we'll be just driving around in circles.
Maybe I'll show the first couple of driving examples, but after that I'll cut them all out.
In complete silence.
I'll just leave them in, shall I? Just death silence, just all the way through it.
That would be entertaining, just for like once or twice.
Yeah.
Just like no, dead silence of driving broken up by the occasional cough or something. I think that could be like a bit of a recurring gag once or twice, but let's not Family Guy it, shall we?
No, let's not do that. Damn lizards. They're so stupid. I mean, come on. The lizards in this game are just dumb.
They're completely R-word.
I mean, they just come at you, despite the fact we've killed all of their friends.
Yeah.
They don't care.
Yeah, you've killed 1,000 of my brethren, but hey, I'm feeling lucky.
Mm.
Oh, you and missed this is a cave.
Yeah, I know I have. But I need to go back this way anyway. But I was going to show you. Remember that thing we were talking about ages and ages and ages ago?
Yeah.
Regarding floating platforms.
Yeah. And how you'd never notice that normally, because nobody looks up.
No, but you would notice the platforms that lead up to it, and then you may have seen it, but still. It doesn't make sense. Just floating ice.
Aren't they invisible from the bottom as well?
I don't think so.
Hmm. Or they're just so unnoticeable that you don't even bother looking up.
No, they are that.
No, they're not invisible. I thought as much.
but the camera is quite low down in this game, so you don't generally see it.
Yeah, but that's pointless.
Now, which one do I want to go into first? Is that the right one?
I just don't understand.
Yeah, you don't need to.
True. Let's just play this and have a good time, shall we?
Yeah, let's try to do that.
Attempt.
We will give it a go. Can't promise anything, mind you.
Yeah.
Just okay, that's all the cogs.
About things feels good.
Have some more of your energy drink. Don't want you yawning through this. Come on.
Oh, sorry. Ugh.
No.
Ha, broken texture.
Mm-hmm. I can't wait to show you some more wonderful things in this game.
Goddamn.
What?
I really should not be drinking these things.
Why?
Because Monster Energy Drink is actually poisonous.
Yeah, only a little.
But...
Oh, shit. Uh-oh.
I mean, my blood is basically 98% caffeine anyway. And yeah, you only have 299, so there's one opal out there.
I'm hoping it's right at the end. I'm hoping I've just missed it along the way.
Yeah, because...
Oh, this is so...
We're not going to want to be editing out an entire section of just wandering around in circles with the both of us becoming more and more pissed off as we can't find this thing.
Yeah, let's not do that.
If it does happen, we'll probably have to edit it out because it'd just be us growing increasingly frustrated.
Yep. Now, do I remember this? I didn't hit that one. The green one. Okay, it's not even that one. Oh, this is going really well.
I do not like this puzzle.
No, it makes sense, but it actually doesn't make sense.
Did you manage to do the piano puzzle in Undertale?
Yes.
Yes, so did I.
Okay, I think I got it.
As depressing as it sounds, I can basically play the entire song now on that piano. I may have to do that during the Let's Play. I might get carried away.
Okay, well, it should be interesting. Oh, fuck, I did that last time. It's that one.
You sure?
Yes, it is that one.
Well, I guess if you know this puzzle practically off by heart, then I'm allowed to know some of these things off by heart.
I don't know this puzzle off by heart. I'd forgotten it. Because fuck this puzzle.
Point withdrawn.
It makes no sense.
It doesn't make any sense, does it?
It's just ice.
Yeah.
Coloured ice. That,
indeed.
That rotates when you shoot it and makes a noise.
It's a very forgettable puzzle.
It is a very forgettable puzzle. No, we can't really get back to the main path this way. Did we go up this one? No, we didn't.
No. I mean, yeah, there are a lot of puzzles which, you know, they're very memorable.
Yes, there are.
Like,
I
can remember the platform puzzle in Rex Marks the Spot because it has a jump that's physically impossible.
Rex Marks the Spot.
Yeah, because the platforms desync and then you have to wait for them to resync. That's going to be fun waiting for.
Oh, that one. Yeah, that one's the best. But totally. Really not.
Yeah, I can remember a few from Mario 64.
Yeah, Mario 64 had some good puzzles.
Yeah. Like, the clock level was quite a
bastard. Tick-tock clock, yeah.
Yeah, because you could,
If
you jumped in at certain times, the whole level was at different speeds, wasn't
it? Yes. If you went in at an o'clock, it would stop completely.
Yeah, which you didn't want, because then it made whole areas inaccessible.
Yep.
I'd like try and time it so that it just came in at a bit of a crawl.
Speaking of crawl.
Yeah. You see there, kids? He pizzed when he should have French fried. If you do that, you're gonna have a bad
time.
There it is.
We're okay.
Oh, cool.
We're okay.
And you've completely invalidated my rather excellent South Park quote.
Oh, I'm sorry. what did you say?
I did the... never mind.
Well, remember I don't watch South Park.
That is true. That's
so it would have been lost on me anyway.
You should definitely see the latest season, because I've never seen that show more on point than with this latest season. It's like, it's crazy relevant, and it's hilarious. I might just send you a link to a place where you can acquire it. Totally legally.
Oh, totally.
Totally.
Totally, yeah. No quotation on that at all.
No. Amazon. You missing something?
A building.
That's weird.
Oh, hang on.
And you got the time trial to go, and yeah, the last Bilby.
Yeah, I could have sworn it was up here.
Huh.
Wow, there is something we've missed.
Do you want me to Google it?
No, I don't need to Google it. If anything, I can just do the cheat. I'll go through the time trial first. If I don't see it on the way, then we'll find it some other way.
Okay.
Oh, look, there's a party of them.
Oh, well, party's over, motherfuckers!
It's like quantum particles. They disperse when you look at them.
Yeah. Relax. That's it's a technically how it works. Apart
from the technically.
Slippery ice and the snow and the downhill bit. It's a sprint to the finish, passing through all the checkpoints as you go.
I know how a race works, Maury.
Thanks for that, Maury. Otherwise, you'll get nothing. Yeah, the point of a race is you go from point A to point B, weirdly.
And you hit checkpoints. God, I never would have got that if you hadn't told me.
Now, a checkpoint is a point in relative space-time at a set coordinate, which, upon passing...
And the tie just walked away.
Yeah. Just walks away halfway through the explanation.
Actually, I wonder if it's in here. Then again, actually, I wonder if it would even exist in the time trial. Because it despawns all enemies.
Yeah. There wasn't a cave you missed because you went back and into it, didn't you? Yeah, we'll check around there.
We'll check. We'll have a look.
It kind of depends on where you end up, though, because if you end up back at the top of the mountain, then I'd say, like, check all the little nooks and crannies up there.
Yeah, but I can't find it during the race. Because it's despawned. If it exists. You know, if something exists, everything despawns. I mean, even the markers where you talk to Maury, they've gone.
Yeah, that's weird.
I wish they did this in Sitting Ducks. Did you ever play that game?
No.
Sitting Ducks was actually a really good game. I enjoyed it. It was a bit slice of life, but with ducks.
Huh.
And if you had a race, it wouldn't despawn anything. And if you hit something, a pedestrian, a wall, a building, even something like a light post, you would fall off your vehicle and lose 3 of the currency.
Wow.
That you would be using. Which, in that game, is feathers.
Weird.
Yeah. So, you know, you could earn money by plucking your own plumage. But
that's... okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, I've been playing this game recently, whenever I have time, called Race the Sun.
You mean around when you're playing Undertale?
I've actually not touched it for a long time. I basically completed it once and didn't feel compelled to play again. I was that satisfied with my experience.
Oh, okay.
So which is a very good thing. It's called Race the Sun, and I can only really play it for 10-minute stretches at a time. Because it's one of those where you're on a course which is procedurally generated.
Right.
So it's always completely randomized.
Hmm.
And, you're a solar craft, and you're racing the sun as it sets.
Okay.
Because as soon as the sun sets and it goes dark, you lose power and you die.
I see. Ooh.
If you're in the shadow of objects that are procedurally generated in your path, you die. If you crash into objects, you die. If you happen to accidentally clip something with your craft's wing, it slows you down and you die.
Oh, right.
but you can, like, collect things to go faster and to, like, make the sun rise a bit further, and as you travel over the horizon, you're catching up to it.
Okay.
Kinda.
Yeah.
Of course, it's setting faster than you travel, so you will run out of time inevitably.
Yes.
But you're basically just trying to delay the inevitable.
Right, okay.
It's really addictive.
Hmm.
Even though, like I said, I can only play it for, like, 10 minutes a day.
Right.
But it's a lot of fun.
That's curious.
Yeah. It's very simple. Like, it only uses geometric shapes. Like, your craft is effectively a triangle.
Right, okay.
And, like, all the things that spawn are, like, spheres, cubes, rectangles.
Yeah.
Although, a rectangle is a cube, but that in itself, not all cubes are rectangles.
Well, remember, a cube is a 3D shape, rectangle is 2D.
Whatever.
You mean squares?
Yeah, same thing.
Gotcha. No, except really
in
not.
3D. Except in 3D. Same thing, but in 3D. Shut up.
Right, shall I use the cheat? To save time?
Save time,
because
yeah.
This is a huge fucking level.
Screw it. Screw the rules, we have cheats.
And I always remember it, because I used it. Wow. There you are.
There it is.
Oh, very the handy. Fucking beginning.
Wow. So it's where that question mark is on the map. Or is that where the time?
No, it never shows you where they are.
Oh, okay.
It never shows you where the buildies are. Otherwise, what would be the point with the cheat?
Fair enough, yeah, fair enough.
There'd be no challenge.
Well, that being said, Tai 2 has something that shows you where everything is.
Yeah, they've got maps, but you have to pay for those.
Yeah, pay
and
for those
very
using...
very expensive.
Pay for those using collectibles, which you don't have to collect. We've been over this before, it's completely pointless.
Oh, this was what the pointless enemy area was for.
Oh, so it wasn't so pointless, was it?
No, I missed this Billy. Sorry, Billy B.
Have you named them all?
They're all just called Billy B.
Okay,
just because it's Bill B.
Fair enough.
Now let's turn that off.
But yeah.
Now I've got to go all the way back up to the top.
Yay!
But let's take the shortcut. Ice will probably be faster. Well, actually, no, because it stops there. Never mind.
Hmm. But yeah, it's a very interesting game. Yeah, and naturally, like, the more stuff you collect and the less you end up clipping stuff, the faster you go until you're basically moving at breakneck speed.
Hmm.
With all these objects hurtling towards you as you just move increasingly faster.
Right.
So it gets really tricky.
Yeah, it sounds like it would be.
Hmm. Yeah. Yeah, it's a lot of fun. Which I can only do for 10 minutes, weirdly.
Yeah, that so is odd. You just run out of fucks.
Well, you play through it once, and then after that, I feel like I've gotten my fix, if you get me.
Yeah, okay.
It's like how now I only go on YouTube once in a day, just to get my daily fix of these particular things, and then that's it, I'm finished.
I wonder if she says anything else.
Probably not.
You're a lifesaver, Ty. Now the children can get back to their homework.
But there are no schools. Aw.
No, there aren't schools.
There are no schools, lady. And what are they even going to do when they grow up? They can't get a job in nowhere.
Early onset dementia. I probably shouldn't joke about that.
It's okay. I doubt there's anybody with dementia watching this video.
He says after, like, however many episodes of inappropriate jokes. Do you know, my tutor called me facile the other day.
Ooh.
I didn't really know what it meant until I googled it, and the definition is someone who makes incredibly inappropriate remarks on serious situations.
That sounds just like you.